You're listening to the audio production of Genesis 1 through 25 Audio Lectures by Tremper Longman III, published by Zondervan and presented by the author. These audio lectures are a unique learning experience. Unlike a traditional audiobook's direct narration of a book's text, Genesis 1 through 25 includes high-quality live recordings of college-level lectures that cover the important points from each chapter, as well as relevant material from other sources.
Welcome to the study of the book of Genesis. Genesis is the foundational book not only to the Torah, which I'll explain in a moment, not only to the Old Testament, but to the entire Bible. Indeed, the name Genesis, which was given to it in early church tradition, means beginning. And it's not only the beginning of the Bible, it tells the story of the beginnings of the cosmos, the beginning of humanity, the beginning of sin, the beginning of redemption, the beginning of Israel, the beginning of the people of God, and we could go on and on. This is, needless to say, an important book. It is, in actuality, though, not a single book. It is a part of a broader composition, which we call either the Torah or the Pentateuch. The Torah Pentateuch is really a single book, which has been divided into five parts, thus the modern term Pentateuch, which means five scrolls, because this book is so long, it couldn't be placed on one scroll. Now, the book of Genesis introduces and provides the backstory for the main story of the Pentateuch, namely the Exodus from Egypt and the journey toward the Promised Land. So, Genesis is kind of like a preamble, but an extremely important one. So it's going to be fun looking at this book and interesting. In terms of genre, in terms of what type of book it is, I find helpful the category theological history. Theological history. And it's like much of the Old Testament, particularly those books in our English Bible, which are found between Genesis and Esther. That is their history in the sense of they're talking about things that actually happened in the past. And so in that sense, their history, their theological history, because rather than having as its main interest politics or military or biography or economics, the focus of this history is on God and on his relationship with his people. We learn about God, or to put it another way, God reveals himself through these pages by showing us how he acts in space and time. So it's theological history in that sense. And it has, you'll have to agree, a kind of story-like feel to it. Now, I'm not using story here in the sense of fiction. Matter of fact, I would, another way of describing what we find in the book of Genesis are story-like histories. And here I'm contrasting that term with what another scholar, Hans Frey, says in his book, The Eclipse of Biblical Narrative, when he calls the kind of theological history that we get in the Bible, history-like stories. Well, in any case, this book is told in such a vivid, exciting way, and it's there to begin to talk about God's redemptive history, which is yet another way we could refer to it. After the account of the creation and the fall, we'll see that God is intent on restoring his relationship with his sinful people. Now, as we think about the structure of this theological history that we call Genesis, there are a couple ways that we can divide it up. Indeed, there's an interesting use of a particular formula that I'll refer to as the Toledot formula. It's a formula that occurs 11 times in the book. Now, Toledot is a Hebrew word which means account. And as I say, 11 times we get an expression that says, this is the Toledot of X. And these Toledotes divide up the book of Genesis. The first one we find is in Genesis 2, verse 4. And it's, this is the Toledot of the heavens and the earth. It seems as if maybe Genesis 1:1 through 2:4a is a introduction of the whole book, and then the first section that can be described as a Toledot is 2:4b through verse 25. Now, this is the only Toledot formula that is an exception to another rule, which is the Toledot of X is otherwise a Toledot of, and then there'll be a personal name. So the very next Toledot is in Genesis 5, verse 1, and it's the Toledot of Adam. And so we go through the book. The Toledot of X is always focusing on the children or offspring of the personal name that is given in the formula. So that's one way to divide up the book. And additionally, I should point out that these Toledot are likely sources that came to the author of the book of Genesis. I'll come back and talk about authorship in just a couple minutes. But first of all, another way of dividing the book, and one that we're going to follow in this study, is a three-part structure that begins by noting that Genesis 1:1 through 11:26 focuses in on the whole world, beginning with creation and taking us up to the moment just before we have the introduction of Abraham. So the narrative focuses the whole world. You're moving rapidly through time, beginning in creation. A common way of referring to these chapters is the primeval history. And then you get a shift in Genesis 11:27, and this will go all the way through 37, verse 1, though I'll typically refer to it as chapters 12 to 37 to kind of simplify it, or 12 to 36. These are the patriarchal narratives. And notice how when you hit Genesis 11:27, that sort of the narrative time slows down. You start covering shorter amounts of time more slowly. You get a focus, a close-up first on Abraham, then on Isaac, and then on Jacob. These are the patriarchs of Israel. Later, biblical books will talk about the God of Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob. And we'll notice that these chapters are filled with what we might call episodic narratives, short episodes about the lives of these three patriarchs. Then we come to Genesis 37 and through 50, and this is the Toledot of Jacob with its focus on Joseph and the other sons of Jacob, most especially Judah. And here we have something that's more like a short story. Matter of fact, a lot of people look at the Joseph narrative as the first short story. It has a more kind of cohesive theme that runs throughout these chapters. So these are the three parts of the book of Genesis that we'll follow in this study. The primeval narratives, Genesis 1 to 11, the patriarchal narratives, Genesis 12 to 36, and the Joseph story in chapters 37 to 50. The question of who wrote the book of Genesis is actually quite disputed among scholars and has been for the past couple hundred years. Traditionally, Moses is said to be the author, even though nowhere in Genesis, indeed in the entire Pentateuch, is Moses named as the author. However, beginning with Joshua 1, referring back to these books, it's often referred to as the law or the book of Moses. And also within the Pentateuch itself, there are a number of references to Moses writing things down. So I'm not going to go into all the details of this debate, but I will present my view of it, which is that Moses is the primary and foundational author of the Pentateuch. And in my opinion, there's no good reason to deny Moses' writing activity in the middle of the second millennium BC. But there are also indications that there are what I would call post-Mosaic additions to the book. References to people, things, events that weren't known to Moses. For instance, even the reference to Abraham's city, Ur of the Chaldeans, contains what scholars call a post-Mosaica, since the Chaldeans didn't occupy the city of Ur or live in lower Mesopotamia until the first millennium BC. There's a reference in Genesis 14 to the city of Dan, which is a city in northern Israel, but doesn't receive that name until the end of the book of Judges. So these might be kind of the tip of the iceberg, and I don't think we can be dogmatic about how much was added by later inspired authors. But the view that I end up with is that Moses is the foundational author. He used sources to write Genesis, the Toledot. And then after Moses, before Revelation came to a close and the Old Testament canon came to a close, later inspired authors may have added, updated matters in the Pentateuch. As we said in the introduction, the book of Genesis is about beginnings. And of course, we're not surprised that the book begins with an account of creation. Indeed, two accounts of creation. The first one we find in chapter 1:1 through 2:4a, and then the second one in 2:4b through verse 25. And we'll see obvious similarities and differences between the two. The first one we might describe as a cosmic creation account. The focus is on the creation of the entire cosmos. And it begins appropriately enough with "in the beginning." Now, the first question we have to encounter is, what kind of literature are we dealing with here? And if you know anything about the discussion around the book of Genesis, that question has been answered from everything from mythology to straightforward literal history. I believe all the signals are telling us that it is history. It is theological history. It is making statements about things that happened in the past, but it's not talking in a kind of straightforward way. There's obvious figurative language in this. account of creation, and in the next account of creation as well. And that's been recognized since the early church. It's nothing new.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.